the Russian dead. I hear people ask me all the time, including my kids, tell us some stories. What was it like to live under Soviet Union? In the Soviet Union, you know, Soviet Russia. So I tell gladly. Today's story is about how I went to university, and there was something funny around the subject called History of the Communist Party of the Soviet Union. Yes, so I was probably, I don't know if it was first or second year of college, I don't know, it was in St. Petersburg, I studied, I don't know, optics and lasers and all kinds of technical strange stuff, but one of the mandatory subjects was indeed History of the Communist Party of the Soviet Union. The abbreviation for that was in Russian КПСС, Коммунистическая партия Советского Союза, which it sounds just like it in English, which is Communist Party of the Soviet Union, CPSS, okay? So a couple of things. By the way, you should know, by the way, it was pure propaganda, okay? Just like pure brainwashing and propaganda. But, you know, I was 18 or 19. It was just like one more subject I kind of didn't like, but I also didn't like cybernetics. So, like, whatever. It just something you had to learn, right? By the way, that's what they do, right? In those types of regimes, they teach you stuff well. The propaganda machine works well. Now, you should know. So a couple of funny things that happened. One is the books, the textbooks you did not buy back then, at least, and when I was a student. They gave you a book at the beginning of the year, right? And then at the end of the school year, you gave it back to the library. Kind of like at Hogwarts, I think, but maybe not. I don't. Anyway, forget Hogwarts. I'm digressing here. So they gave us books that said History of CPSS, КПСС, Коммунистической партии, okay? Good. And then, amazingly, on day two or first lecture or whatever it is, somebody, all of a sudden, people, management, whoever, they get us all in a big auditorium, something bad happened. What happened? Well, somebody wrote the word said on many books, okay? So instead of just History of Communist Party, it said said History of Communist Party, okay? So that was, and by the way, you should know the word history, story in Russian, has actually two meanings. It means history, but also means story. So you could interpret this as a sad story of the Communist Party, okay? I thought it was incredibly clever, but people were outraged, of course, because you defaced a book, the holy, I mean, there was no Bible, but the History of the Communist Party was as close to the Soviet Bible, I guess, as it got. Right. And so they wanted to expel the person, but of course they never found that person who was probably clever or something, lived on the edge. So they never found that person. Don't know who it was. The subject itself started at 8 a.m., which was very early, okay? So I remember going in there, and we were taught by the head of this Department of History of Communist Party of the Soviet Union. I won't mention his name, but anyway, a couple of things. So he would all. So two interesting things about him. Three. One is he would always come. He was a war veteran, and he would always come in his Soviet officer uniform with medals and everything. He looked very impressive, but also crazy. Number two, he always had one or two really young, really attractive, really female assistants, you know, who would sort of help out in the auditorium, and that was probably the main attraction of this class that kept us awake. And then number three, which was completely nuts, he loved to sing, okay, and also I think he was very patriotic, which is good. It's good to love your country. But he would routinely start the class by turning on music. You know, he had vinyl records back then. No, not yet iPhone. This is Steve Jobs, not born yet, probably. But he had vinyl and some kind of a turntable or whatever, gramophone, some kind of a thing that he would put the vinyl. And what would we listen to? He would put on, as he would put it, a favorite song of the of Lenin. Okay, and there were a few that he interpreted as the great revolutionary chief's favorites. And then we would listen to it loudly, and then he would stand up and he would join in and then sing with whoever, and then he said, please stand up, students, we will all sing. And again, when you're 18 and with a couple of attractive female assistants, okay, so I remember you stand up, it's 8 a.m., I'm barely awake, and, but you, so you were saying, complete lunacy. But that's how it was. So I thought it was really funny. By the way, years later, I left Russia by then, but I learned that after the breakup of Soviet Union, and kind of, it was very dramatic and traumatic, and so this person, our head of the department, they found him, he went nuts. No joke, and it's kind of sad, of course, but he went completely crazy, basically. He lost it. He, wearing all his uniform and the medals and everything, he was on the streets still singing, and he was no longer able to cope with reality. They took him away. He might be gone by now. He was up there. Anyhow, so that's one interesting episode about the sad history of the Communist Party of the Soviet Union, which was the subject that I studied in my university. I hope that gave you a little bit of a glimpse of into the Soviet life. You know, more to come.